Bravo.
Toad.
You're a librarian.
Oh, that's generous.
You're a librarian.
Oh, I'm ripping my hair out. We are going to go thrifting for some pictures for our gallery wall that we have yet to materialize, but it's gonna live right here on our like landing of the stairs. And we have a lot of pictures that we thrifted a while ago at the Long Beach flea market. Some of you probably saw that vlog.
Yeah, that was a while ago now.
Yeah, we're slow moving on this. I mean, decorating a house just takes a really long time. But we think we need more pictures, so we're just gonna go to like some local thrift stores today, consignment shops, stuff like that, and see what we can find. And first, we are going to like map out what we already have and then what we think we need based on like sizes of the pictures and also like shapes, directions of the frames. I guess we should like lay it all out right here.
Yeah, first I want to decide how big of it needs to be.
Okay.
So what do you think? From down there, because that's like the main view
point,
it's supposed to have. Do you like what this looks like right now?
Mm-hmm.
Because I don't think they should be too low.
No.
Because then you're like hip checking them as you go up the stairs.
No.
Like maybe they're only like this.
Yeah, maybe they're just that like middle block.
And then does that go like right underneath the chandelier? Or a little bit into the chandelier?
No. It's like, there's like this much. Like.
There's a gap a little chandelier.
Yeah.
Do you want to see it a little bit closer maybe?
Yeah, maybe a little. Yeah, like that's probably good. Yeah,
so I think it's like 5 foot. Okay. 5 foot tall. And we'll just do like only 3.5 foot wide. 5 foot by 3.5. Because we don't want it to get too close to this wall, right? Like that'd be kind of weird if like.
Yeah.
So how much space over here do you think you want?
Like that.
So it's only 3 foot wide is how wide it's gonna be.
So we're screwed?
Like we don't have, it's not, well no, we're not screwed, but we don't
Do we even have space right here to lay it out?
Yeah. And then 3 foot wide to the jute rug.
Oh my god, that's narrow.
Yeah, it's not that wide.
It's really narrow.
So do you want to make it so it gets a little bit closer to that wall? Or it could go that way a little bit. Okay, so, and then maybe like, 4 inches off this wall, 45 inches. Okay, so here are a bunch of pieces of art and frames we've collected over time, a lot from the flea market and stuff. We have our area kind of laid out with the tape measure, and this is my little marker with the firewood. I don't know if we'll use this Frida picture, but this is kind of the vibe, and we're trying to figure out what more we need for this. Oh, that'd be cool maybe to have like some mirrors in there. But we're gonna go probably thrift some other pieces. Like looking at this, I thought we were gonna maybe need like a bigger piece, but I think if you get a bigger piece because of the size of the gallery wall, it'll take up too much room, like the size that we have.
More horizontal pieces.
Yeah.
Right?
Probably some horizontal ones like that one.
I feel like the Frida and that guy are too close. Can you put Frida in the corner? Take that square mirror out especially.
This one?
Yeah, the tray.
So yeah.
What about that other mirror? Do you feel like it's too, I feel like it's too like orange.
Yeah, it's a little orange.
Like it looks
I like the unique shape to it though, it's kind of cool.
I do like that. I wonder if we could put a picture in
it. Yeah, probably. Okay, we're going to our first stop. Kind of like locals here, huh?
Yes.
We get down here quite a bit. They got a lot of furniture. They have this like upper area that normally has a lot of art.
Mm-hmm.
Normally bigger pieces. I don't really remember seeing small things here, but
let's see.
Maybe we weren't keeping our eye out for the small pieces, so I bet we'll find some stuff. You want an angel float in there?
I mean, I do like angels, but I feel like those are kind of creepy. They're like Something's weird.
They're kind of cool though. But I see it. Sometimes like faces like that in art can be like a little creepy.
Do you want that?
No. I like that frame better though.
Okay, well.
But the other frame is pretty too.
This is like, this would be the biggest one we'd have.
Yeah. Do you think it's too big? Or would it be okay?
I think it could be okay.
What are they up to?
Lewis Gart. Looks like... Oh, it looks kind of weird.
Are they like kidnapping girls?
Yeah. Yeah, he's like pulling her out of there. Yeah, that's kind of weird.
Alright.
Not the vibe?
Not the vibe for us. I like the frame though.
Yeah, look at this one up here. Like, I don't like necessarily like the frame, but the paint.
It would be nice for like a little bit of contrast.
Yeah, though. This will get it down.
Should we
put this clock in it?
It kind of creeps me out. I don't know why.
You're feeling creepy.
I guess so. Okay, maybe you should stop. I'm kind of nervous. Stop. Oh my god. This is so awkward. Okay, get out.
I like that one.
What about these ones over here?
So that one fits the horizontal vibe. Kind of like this girl. But I feel like
do you like her?
Yeah, but I feel like the colors don't really match with what we have going.
True.
But I do like that one over there. Yeah, that one is freaking pretty.
Is that the Taj Mahal? I know, Russian.
Russian art. I like that one. All right, we just went into another small little, it's like an antique consignment store.
Oh yeah, it's like very,
very, very small.
Like French inspired.
Yeah.
Like it's just like super European, like nothing in there is modern.
No, not at all.
Like, it's so cool.
Yeah, and it's run by this older lady, and her friend were just sitting there having a glass of wine, some cheese, hanging out. And when we were picking all these out, they were like kind of critiquing them.
Yeah, the one and, girl was an art critic.
Yeah, giving us information on them. So this one you guys saw, we got this one, but then we got these three little...
we got this little sketch of...
They have like months on them.
Like a mountain lake, which is very like, we spent a lot of time That's in us. Places like yeah. that. And then this is Italy.
This is Venice, Italy. Over there, a little watercolor painting.
Yeah, so we're just manifesting.
And then this is a oil-based Paris painting.
Yeah.
And this is the one that's going to go above our
chair. And we love old ladies.
Yeah, they're so
sweet.
And
their energy, like I just want to hang out with them and talk to them and be around them. All right, I am getting ready now. And I decided I wanted to do like a little vlogging around what a typical work day kind of looks like as a blogger. Alexa, stop. Step one is you're always listening to Lainey. Just kidding. I kind of just wanted to do a little something like showing what it's like working as a blogger because I feel like a lot of people are actually very curious and also very misinformed what it's like to be a blogger. So I kind of just thought it would be fun to like share more. And like you guys also ask in the comments about business advice and like what it's like running a business and things like that. So we are trying to share that more. One of the things that is like kind of hard about this job and people ask about it a lot is if I get sick of getting ready all the time. And honestly, yeah, I do kind of get sick of it's hard having like your face be so much of your brand and your work because it's like you can't just like not worry about that sometimes, which is annoying. Sometimes I just don't want to have to worry about that. Like I don't want to have to look cute. I don't want to have to model. I don't want to have to like dress cute. I mean, today I look like an actual toad. I mean, this t-shirt is very cute from Twin Flames, but I looked like a toad with my outfit and everything. No shade to toads, I like toads. I feel like that is just like a hard thing that sometimes I'm like, oh, it'd be so nice if I could just like not worry about that, like having a bad hair day. Like it doesn't matter because I don't have to go take a picture and share it with the internet. And honestly, like, this isn't to complain about my job either. Like, I love my job. If I didn't, I wouldn't do it. But I just wanted to share, like, a little bit of what it's like and be candid and real with you guys too, because it's one thing to just go around and be like, everything's perfect, I love it just the way it is, and it's another thing to be like complaining about everything. So I think when I'm being realistic, we're just somewhere in between. Like, everything is not perfect. There's things that are annoying, there's things that are hard, and we still like our job, we're still happy. So that's where we're at, if we're being real. So getting ready is something that can be kind of annoying, but it's part of the job. Just like maybe wearing a suit or like wearing heels to a job is part of your guys' jobs, I'm sure. And maybe sometimes you're like, I really don't want to have to dress like that today, but it's just part of my job. It's like something that bothers me about my job sometimes, and sometimes it doesn't bother you. So I am getting ready right now for, I'm gonna shoot a couple of things later. And all right, sorry, I have to do my brows, but I'm gonna take some pictures in a little while and film a couple of things. Clayton is actually in the middle of editing. He's the girl boss.
I am the girl boss.
Tell them what it's like being an editor.
Sit at the computer a lot.
About how many hours?
Press buttons. Hours a week at my computer, probably
editing.
Between the videos we do every week, probably like 8 to 10 hours between the two.
I'd say it's more like 12.
12 hours. 10 to 12 hours.
He does a good job. He'll be editing this one soon.
That he's editing that right one, now. Yeah, next, yeah. It's like an inception.
Yeah, like you finish one and then like guess who's there waiting for you? Another one.
They just keep coming. We
make
them.
They're fun. Yeah. So I just grabbed some products out of my closet in there that I needed to get ready with. And while Clayton's working on that, I'll just do the things that I can do. Like, I'll shoot and film things that I can do without him. Once I've done everything that I can self-achieve, I will go bother him and be like, can you... Oh my god, that was sketchy. Can you release yourself so I can have your skills. I've never used this sparkle product before. Kinda just like spilled it all over my face. Look myself in the eye. I am not a beauty influencer, a beauty blogger. Heard of the word blogger to influencer. I like never called it influencer until a few months ago, I feel like. Before this, I should have vlogged then, but I forgot. But we were having a little meeting with Molly. Molly hasn't been in the vlog for so long. You guys are probably worried about her, but she's here. She's fine. I don't know why I haven't vlogged her. But yeah, so we were actually having a meeting with Molly down at the kitchen table. It's weird when you work from home, like your boundaries are very blurred. So kitchen table becomes the main meeting place. We're having a meeting for Boyd Fall, which we're very excited about. We actually have a surprise trip planned next week. We'll probably have already gone on it by the time this vlog posts, I guess. Or no. I think we're leaving for a trip the day this vlog will be posted. But we are going to shoot our campaign for fall next week, and we're very excited for that. Just been like running around crazy for Boyd. It's like we have meetings every single week for like marketing, social media. We have fit meetings all the time. We have design meetings. It's just like, it's so much added things on top of everything that we did before we owned a company. And it's a lot. It's a lot. Anyone who owns a company knows it's a lot. And obviously we're like so excited and so grateful to be doing that. We're very happy, but I do think it's just funny. Like, I don't know what I was thinking sometimes. Like, I don't know what I thought it was gonna be like sometimes. I feel like I didn't think that one through that much. Like, again, I'm not saying I regret it or anything, but I do feel like I just didn't fully comprehend or even try to comprehend the amount of like responsibility and time that would be necessary to run a whole ass company. So joke's on me. Mm-hmm. Yep, I am the one who jokes on. That's just a peek into some stuff, just like a little moment in a typical work day. All right, so I didn't remember to bring the vlog with us, but after I got ready, I filmed those things, and then I stole Clayton from the editing chair, and we just went and shot this look in a little parking garage. Parking garages are a very popular place to shoot. They're always really good lighting, and they're like pretty private and like controlled with weather and everything. So that's always kind of like a nice hack when you're just trying to shoot like an OOTD and get good lighting and everything. So just finished that, and now I think since we have a trip coming up next week, I'm trying to cram like a lot in, and I just filmed fall trends this week, but I think I'm also gonna film my next Fashion Friday video maybe tomorrow, just get like a little bit up ahead of schedule, because I know that I will always like thank myself in the end for doing things a little bit sooner than I needed to, just because other things come up and then I'm like, oh my god, thank god I did that when I did, because I don't know how I would have done it otherwise. So it's kind of just insurance for myself. So I think I'm gonna open up all of that can of worms and style it and, you know, start my next chaotic venture. Forgetting to pull out the vlog while I'm working because I'm just like busy working. It's now nighttime and Clayton has still been editing the video. He literally, it's been hours. It's taken forever. His computer was like not working and yeah, just some stuff like that. I am in the office now. This is my very bootleg tripod for y'all. I'm just looking at my time blocking, see for tomorrow and also what I got done today. I love highlighting things, checking it off my list. So it's like 10 now and I just finished linking all of the products in my fall trends video, which is going live tomorrow. It took me over 2 hours to link all that stuff, which is fine. It's just like, it's just really like tedious, you know? One of those things, everybody has tasks in their job that they find tedious, and scouring the internet for links is one of them for me, but I know it's very helpful for you guys and it's part of my job. Ooh, I never did that. Okay, I did do that. I didn't really look at my time blocking today. So some of the stuff that I wanted to do, I didn't even remember to do, which is silly. But I did work out and we did go play Pepper at the park, which is, I'm happy that we did that. I'm happy to prioritize those things, moving my body. Shoot, I didn't do that. Okay. I did do that. I did do that. I just wanted to do like a little recap of sharing like bits of the workday, even though that was like very chaotic energy. I did just like I said, wanted to touch on kind of like what it looks like behind the scenes of this, just because so many people assume that this job is really easy. And I'm always like a little bit hesitant to talk about it because I don't want to ever make it sound like I'm complaining about my job being hard or anything, because I don't mind hard work. I just wanted to like shed light on what it's actually like for people who are curious and for people who assume that it's easy and they're not even like curious to see what it's actually like. I can't really help those people because they already have their minds made up to kind of just like project whatever they're feeling onto somebody else's life. But I do have one thing to say to those people. If it's so easy, you should do it. Because, like, hell yeah. So yeah, that's my one little sassy remark for this vlog. And if you guys like seeing kind of like work-related things behind the scenes of the industry, let me know. I can do more in future vlogs, and just thought it'd be fun to share a little take my vlog fam to work with me. Like when you used to bring your parents to school and they'd share their job career day kind of vibes. That's it for today.
All right, big guy. I love your outfit.
How is it today?
So cute.
No Crocs.
But we need to go to the mall and seek fancy outfits for you. We have an engagement party to go to tonight. It's our first Persian party.
Mm-hmm. Should be interesting.
And we have to be fancy. We can't look like this.
We're going to Samir and Aiden's engagement party today, tonight.
Are you nervous or something?
No, I'm not nervous. Are you?
Why are you acting like that?
Well, I want to know, you know, where your head's at, you know? Where's your head at, you know? It's early days. And,
it's not early days.
Are you going to party tonight?
No, I'm not going to party tonight.
I think you might be turning up.
No, Samira wants me to take a shot, and I'm not gonna do that.
You're not?
No.
Not even for Sammy Raisin's engagement party?
No.
That's
I might.
That's strong.
Get a shot glass and fill it with water.
Toss it out behind your back?
Yeah, fill it with water, and then let her think I took a shot with her, because I think it would make her really happy.
I heard she'd be so stoked.
Yeah. But I do not.
Operation, get Delaney to take a fake shot.
I do not.
I think we make that happen.
Yeah. Because I could just be like walking around a bit or something.
Yeah. I'll like have a water bottle in my hand and then you can pour it out and then I'll pour yours in.
Somebody's gonna see it though. We have to be sneaky.
Yeah, I definitely am not trying to get faked tonight.
No, but like I'm gonna have a cocktail or like a glass of wine or two.
Yeah, yeah, me too. But
like we'll enjoy it. But a shot.
I was considering like letting loose. Considering letting loose, but that's not.
Hey, do your thing.
It's not gonna happen.
If you wanna let loose, I will drive you home.
No. I don't think so. I need to get something fancy though.
Yeah.
And I'm gonna get a suit because we're going to Italy for a wedding.
Yoles.
But my friend Kale's going to a suit place soon. So I think I'm gonna wait for that. I want it to be like a really cool suit.
Okay.
But like, I'll see what they have.
You know when
I was gonna
you
call,
can go.
I was gonna, he said we could go right when they get here.
It will be ready for you today?
Yeah, he said it'd be ready.
The guy did?
Kale said it would be.
Should you maybe get the actual person who's making it?
Yeah.
Sword for that?
I should. But Kale might be a spokesman.
Kale's not a spokesman.
I was thinking about just touching him with Kale and be like, dude, is it worth the wait or should I go today? But I don't think if I get a suit from Nordstrom's today that it would even be ready for tonight because it needs to get tailored.
Oh, they don't, you can't just buy a suit ready.
Well, then it won't be like tailored to me. And I don't want to have like a suit that like is, that's like friggin' perfect for
so
me.
When is Kale getting back?
Monday, this Saturday actually.
Tomorrow?
Week Friday.
Oh. I mean, today's Saturday.
I'm gonna call him.
Which is what day of the week? The 4th? I mean, the month?
That is the 4th, yeah.
The 4th, okay. Yeah, I mean, if you went right when, what are you going on the 5th?
I'll talk to him.
This might take like 2 weeks to get your suit. You should give yourself at least 2 weeks.
2 weeks,
to get
yeah,
it,
yeah. Alright, but I gotta find something for tonight, so I don't know what tonight will be.
Well,
what is the vibe for tonight?
Vibe is you need to dress freaking nice. Persian people are dressing really nice. Ooh. They're wearing suits.
So. Yeah, this is like a, I think we're going to like the Met Gala tonight.
We are.
Pretty much, right? This poor thing.
Can you literally
this
help
poor
her?
Thing needs some TLC.
Looks good to me. I think that's too small.
Is that?
I don't know.
I just get it and like wear it every day. What if I just came down the stairs every morning and just whatever I was wearing?
That would be lovely.
Put my suit on.
That'd be lovely.
a softer shoulder line definitely helps you here. Because here you're basically filling out the jacket versus the jacket kind of building you. So what I would do here is that I would definitely pinch the sides in by quite a bit. Based on that, and kind of shape that, shorten the sleeves, and that's how it's cut for you. Let me just see what a size down looks like. How many size?
Now we're in good hands. Well, we didn't know what we were doing without you. Yeah.
So I'm taking a look to see what the shoulders look like.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
And scoot up clean the stick.
So this is a little bit shorter.
This is gonna be a little bit shorter, but I think with your frame, it actually still works well.
Yeah. And I see what you mean with the shoulders.
Yeah, that looks better.
A touch smaller. I think we could do the 50, to be honest.
What was it? What is this? Is this a 50?
This is a 50. So European 50, US 40.
Oh, so you're right, babe.
Yeah.
Because I was at the other store, I'm like, these look huge.
Yeah.
Because they're all 50s and 52s.
Oh, wrong one. Also, with the jacket, you always want to button top one only.
Okay.
Yeah, so basically, with the jacket, the idea is to kind of enhance the V shape. So broaden the shoulders, little waist. Kind of like reverse pair. The Dorito.
Yeah,
the Dorito.
So I mean, I would still pinch it in, but I think it's much less than we have to do on this one.
Yeah.
And
that looks good.
The sleeves look almost perfect. I think with the dress shirt on, we'll be able to kind of finish that.
Right.
That looks pretty good.
That looks nice. Yeah.
What's happening?
Got my suit.
Rudy to the rescue.
Taylor, what's that?
Rudy to the rescue.
Rudy just straight up saved us. We were at like two other places. And
what time is it right now?
3:30.
Yeah. What time is the party?
They're gonna have it tailored for me in 2.5 hours.
Mm-hmm.
I had strong intuition on this
one. You did.
We were at Bloomingdale's, and I was like, I need to get out of here.
You knew it.
I knew I needed to come to Nordstrom's because I knew Rudy was waiting.
I love when you follow your intuition.
Thanks.
Getting ready to go. I'm gonna steam my dress and do my hair and makeup. I'm not sure like how I should do my hair with this dress yet. It's kind of like a sleek, little like, it gives me like Grecian goddess vibes. Grecian, I feel like I should just say Greek. And then I don't wash my face, so I'm just gonna like do my makeup over my makeup. It's really, really like a bad idea. That's probably what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna get ready. Clayton has to go pick up his suit because he's fancy. He gets tailored suits. I'm actually like so excited that we have like something fancy to go do. And special, and I am chugging water. This is my second water of the day because I know we're gonna have some drinks. So
what does it mean? Bite me to the bleed. Met you in the
my finished makeup and my hair. I'm just holding this little bit up with this. I'm for like kind of an old Hollywood glam. I'm actually gonna ride in the car with this little poof because it's just like helping my hair set even more and like keep it a little off my face over there. So I'll show you my outfit in the mirror. But actually like makeup touch up instead of redoing my makeup, I feel like I actually looked better, turned out better. than I could have expected. And then Clayton, come show us your outfit. This is my outfit. I don't know where my purse is. I have a little like gold sparkly purse. My dress is from House of CB. My heels are old Alias May. And this is like really close to being an hip slip, but I'm just gonna pray for the best.
I'll be on lookout.
Okay. Look at this guy. I mean, I am so crushing.
Bravo. Bravo. You look beautiful.
Thank you, baby. You look so nice. This is
just... I need to find more events.
Insane.
Come on, get some red carpet events going. Let's go.
Let's go.
You need me there?
I'm there.
You need a date? دلم شدی همه چیز دلم تو رو که میبینم به تر مرتب میریز دلم فکر کن ازت دل بکنم اونم با این حال بدم تو که دیدی به خاطرت به دنیا پشت پا زدم همین یه شب و راه بیا به خاطرم کوتاه بیا آخه بگو این همه ناز و عشوه از کجا بیا قرار نیست من یه تنه دلم برات شور بزنه اصلا چرا آدم باید حرفای ناجور بزنه عوامو داشته باش گلم تو هم یواش یواش گلم قلب منو ببر ولی دل بسوزون براش گلم چجوری عزیز دلم شدی همه چیز دلم تو رو که میبینم به تر مرتب میریز دلم خونه دل بکنم اونم با این حال بدم تو که دیدی به خاطر